heck am I gonna do with this? Is the question. And I'm like, I have this idea. And I don't know what color. I've used Australian sienna gold and burgundy. I think I'm gonna go I'm just gonna have to choose something. I don't know. I'm not worried too much. I'm gonna put some vermilion on my palette. Vermilion is kind of in this acrylic paint. It's kind of orange. I kind of like it. So some vermilion, and also. Brush. I also used a kind of pinky colour, actually skin tone pink. I wonder if I should move that across. Don't want to put my no. Okay, vermilion. Burgundy. Burgundy is my other colour. So burgundy on its own is a pretty boring colour. It's a kind of school uniform burgundy, but if I mix it with that orange, I get quite an interesting kind of colour. And I'm going to show what happens. So I've got these, right? So if I put a bit of orange into that burgundy, that's quite a nice, I quite like that colour. It's some, I can even do a bit more. That's a very pleasant sort of brown. So I've got that. So I definitely need some white as well, and I need my medium. So I need some thin painting medium. Very thin painting medium. I've got a little bit in here. Might need to squirt a bit more in here, actually. My thin painting medium. You can see that. So I'll just... This is very thin. It's not quite as thin as water, but it's pretty thin. And if I add a tiny bit of water to it, I can make it thinner. But I'll just leave it like that. White is my other option, is my other thing I'm going to use in that pinky colour. I'll put that pinky on my palette. So I just have this skin tone light. And actually it's quite a nice skin tone colour. It doesn't really do much, but I'm just going to have a little bit on the palette for... Rather than mix it up, I'll just grab it out of there. For where I need to go into the light skin tones. And some white, and I'm actually going to use gesso. I'm not going to use titanium white or acrylic paint because I like the bitter tooth that's in gesso. And there's a bit of chalky kind of thing in there, so it gives a bit of tooth. So when I do a real thin paint, grab nicely onto that. I'll get some good brush marks and the paint won't actually just sit on top of the paint. The thin paint won't just sort of pool there, or drip. It'll just kind of, the brush marks will soak into that gesso a bit. So that's a really weird palette. That is a very strange palette. But that's the palette I'm going to use. Nothing blue. So do I want some grey on there? That was a question, but I'm not gonna. I wonder if I put. I'm just gonna see what if I put a bit of white into that mix of burgundy and orange. A bit more white. I get Yeah, okay. I don't know if I put a lot of white in. We'll get there. If I put more orange into that, more vermilion. That's a really strange palette. Okay. Am I making my life hard by not adding something cool? Something blue or black? No. Or yellow. Oh, yellow. I don't know, I'll just start painting and see what happens. So I need my rag. Okay, so I'm going to emphasize those eyes first. So I quite like this brush at the moment, this one. It's a round brush, it's a little bit pointy, and it's not that small. So I'm going to try and do my detail with that. Put some medium on my palette. And, alright. So if I just... see if I can make this a bit more interesting. So that's... oh, so I might work with two brushes. A little kind of stiff square brush that I can chisel my work backwards with. Now, where is one that might have to do? Oh, alright, so I'm going to wet it. Wipe it and now it's sort of wet and I'm just gonna take off what's not quite good there or smooth that edge a bit. So for my mid-tone, if I take a some of this with the white in it. No, maybe not. Maybe what I need to do, actually, while I think about it, is thin it out with medium. So I won't use it with the white, I'll use it with the medium. And if I thin it out with medium, then it goes on not as dark. So I'll be able to kind of get a little bit of kind of mid-tone that way. More like a watercolor effect, which is what I'm trying to achieve. Meaning, yeah, that's quite nice actually. Which means I need a third brush. A third brush to move that around with. Go back to the dark. So I use this one for the dark. Tiny bit of brow there. There's a funny mark there. I need to change that, don't I? Take this. Yeah. I've got to really know what's on my brush as well. Gee, I've got to lift that cheek a bit. I'll get some dark into there. I'll put some getting a feel for this. And then I'll do something interesting, I think. Not sure how to achieve what I want to achieve, though. There's some big truck pulled up outside. So I made the mistake of not saving the video. That probably would have been a good to save from here. And I really should try and save the ones I want to keep before they disappear into the cyber rubbish tip. Yeah, So that was a bit of a disaster, really. All right, I'm going to use some skin tone light now. This skin tone I have. Just to get that bit of ear down. And that bit of, I don't know what that thing's called that kind of sticks into the ear there. So, what's that? Yeah, she does look like she's got one side in the shade and one side in the light. The hair's a bit darker there, so this is a bit brighter here. And with that bright hair, I could actually do just the orange on it. Do I want to do that? So thin orange again with medium. It's vermilion, really. So I could probably just. I think I'll be right with that. Bit of hair, kind of in the wind. She's a bit messy. But on the other side, I've kind of grayed that hair off, which is really interesting. Oh, yes, I did too. So I actually had a gray on my palette. I might have to put that on my palette. So the gray, this gray, which I'd pre-mixed and it has got gesso in it. I've mixed it with gesso. It's a really light grey, so it's not white, it's light grey. If I put that on my palette and I'll put it next to the white, and that's gonna give me that really weird kind of negative looking. See the grey next to the white? So they're my two whites. Well, the pink really is white as well. So what I want to do is mix some of that grey with, some of this grey, maybe with, that's dry already, maybe with that burgundy orange mix, or maybe just with orange to give me my cool, like in the shadow side here. So rather than mix with white, or rather than have it thin, that gives me the shadow side. So that's interesting. That works. That actually looks, it's okay. I'm quite happy with that. I could probably use a bit of medium with it. But because I've only got white now, I probably don't need medium. So, that's interesting. And then the other thing I'm wondering now is the dark bits in through here. Do I want to go dark with burgundy or just more grey? You know, I'm going to try burgundy and more grey. So I'm going like, oh no, I don't know if that. that's going to work or not, but I'm going to put a bit here just to test it. So it's kind of, yeah, I don't know about that. Let's put a couple of bits there and stand back and look. That's okay. It's okay. I think. I don't want too much of that. So do I want to use... I don't mind that. I don't know. I don't know if I could carry that on that shadow side or keep to what I've got there. All right, I'm going to use that burgundy, but no, I'm going to use that with more this, with more grey, with more orange in it. Just to take this. So normally, like, I would use white in the light side of the face, you know, to get your lights. But what I'm actually doing is using the white in the shadow side of the face. And using thin paint without white on the light side of the face, but with the white underneath. So I think that's the plan. I think that's the way to do this, to get this kind of weird negative, like, you know, when you get a photo and you turn it, you reverse it so it's in the negative, kind of like that. So you've got the black where the white is and the white where the black is. That's the kind of feel I want for this painting. If that makes sense. Yeah. Things we do, hey? So very limited palette, but weird, a very weird palette, and a very, very strange palette indeed. Oh, maybe I need to, yeah, take this. A very weird palette. So this grey as an alternative to white is very interesting. Okay. Means I could put that probably in the mouth as well. Oh, be careful with that mouth. No, that didn't work, so I'm going to wipe that off. Wipe it off. Wipe it off. I've also got to be careful that I don't wipe paint on these pants, the pants I'm wearing, because they're actually my reasonably good pants. Okay. Hi there, Michael. How are you? Another lovely day, another lovely afternoon here in sunny old Adelaide. Good, that's good. Good, good, good. I'm good too. I am good. I haven't done this for a couple of weeks. I got kind of sidetracked and so busy. Trying to finish this little commission portrait, not this one, a different one, and so I forced myself to sit down with it this morning and do an hour. I put the timer on because I really wanted to get to this, and so, oh, she's smiling now. What have I been up to? Well, I've been looking after the, we've got the new kitten, so I've been negotiating between him and Bubbles, and they seem to be getting along okay now. Like, well, no, not really. The dog chases cat wherever possible, but the cat's got the guts to sneak out and, you know, sneak past the dog. And sometimes the dog just can't be bothered, and sometimes she chases him. And I've put up a little kitty gate between the hallway and the kitchen area so the cat can escape whenever it needs to. So that's been busy, and I've been teaching a lot. Teaching a fair bit. Yeah. And I've been preparing a kind of lesson thing for the when am I doing it? Next week. Next week I am. And I also started another chess competition on chess.com, doing chess 960. And suddenly I got like 12 games to play, so I've been playing chess a bit. Chess 960, which is actually different than normal chess. It's a random kind of chess. It starts with a bit of a random kind of fun. Starts with a random random positions of the pieces, the major, the bigger pieces, not the pawns. That's very interesting. Okay, shadow. Are you like a grandmaster in chess? No, well, no. So, what am I? So I've only started playing 960. So my, what do you call it? Not score. My rating is 1150. A grandmaster is over 2000, I think, in anything. And then for my daily chess, my rating is 1450. So probably average. Average, maybe. Average, reasonable. Like, I give people a hard time. But the highest rating I've played is 1900, and I lost really badly every time. One of my most frequent players is 16 something that I play all the time, but he wins most of the time, and I've won one game against him, and we've drawn about two games, and the rest I've lost. Yeah, that's for daily chess, so you know, where you have minimum sort of games of 24 hours a move, and then you can sort of time them to more than that. I don't like playing, you know, fast chess. Like, I panic. I don't like the pressure, so I don't play it. The faster chess, you know. Yeah. Do you play? It's a really good game. I really enjoy it. Really, especially with this chess.com online, because I need straight white. Yeah, just had some games going all the time. So I've always got a few games going. Play with a few old friends that I used to play years ago too. So that's been good. It's just fun too, because, you know, it's something to do games you sort of play rather than, you don't always have to talk about politics or whatever's the latest thing that we're talking about. Yeah. That's looking interesting. Might reshape. I think I'm happy with that pink colour. I could lighten it up with a bit of white, but I think it's okay at the moment. I'll keep it. Keep some of the detail on that. I don't need that grey where I go down a key. When I go into the shadow side, I need to mix with grey. That one, I think. Now, what am I going to do now? Dear, should I, what am I doing? Pink on the... I gotta do something with this background. It's terrible. I wonder if I should put a bit of pink in it. So if I take this pink and mix it with white, so it's a bit of a maybe much lighter version. Oh, I should try and draw this on my palette. Oranges and burgundy. So if I put a bit of burgundy into that, oh, too much. I just whacked a whole heap of burgundy into that colour and trashed it. Maybe with a bit of grey in it. See what happens if I kind of such a strange colour palette. I'm not going to do drips. No drips. More of that pink I want. That's the fridge going. Maybe I should turn it off. Turn off the fridge. postmodern portraiture. This is, no, what is it? Not postmodern portraiture. Oh, I just lost all that hair. This is contemporary. Contemporary. Ah, dry a bit off. So, drips. Drips are evil. Well, yeah. They're all right. They're not that bad. So I think I want to, do I need to exaggerate that shadow a bit or no? Yes, yes, no. Okay, no drips, no drips. But thin paint's okay, we'll do thin, but not drips. Thin, but not drips. I actually quite like drips though. But I'm a little bit self-conscious about drips now. Okay, so I'll take that neck up there because that. Oh my god, I don't think we can be friends. Because of drips. Yeah, I know. No, I know. I agree. You don't want to overdo the drips. Maybe you could have one drip. Couldn't you? Just a one drip. I'm blending. What about blending? What do you think of blending, you know? Is blending bad? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Should I do it now? Blending, hey? No drips and no blending. It's a bit of this grey. Right. Oh, I have to put in a bit of a cleavage as well. Where does that cleavage go? Okay, now we. Ooh, where's my water? Blending is cool. Oh, okay, so you like blending. See, I don't blend much either. That's something I don't do, is blend. I sort of put stuff on and leave it. But the thing with oil painting is, and this is not oil painting, by the way, when you oil paint, you need to blend. Sort of. I think I'll bring that. I'll just give that a bit more of a. Very hard to blend with acrylic paints anyway. Because you don't. Oh, is that cleavage too orange. Oh, okay. Put a little bit of, more of it onto the, just tweak that shape a bit. Can't have saggy boobs, hey? Well, you could, but can't. I've got to have, these are just little boobs. Because, you know. Okay, well, now I need to, what now? What now? Some tonal dress or something. Some tea. I'll have some tea. Well, let's look at this sleeve in that dress. Alright, so I'm going to put some background in there. Good background. And the background was light, isn't it? I'm going to put a light. This white and pink. So, get rid of that. There. Here comes a drip, okay? One, oh, there's a drip. Oh my gosh. Now you can hardly see it. It disappeared. Okay. Little bit of turn, little bit of, okay, I'm gonna use orange. Oh, and orange and burgundy mixed together. Orange and burgundy mixed together. Who would have thought? Let's get that edge of the dress there. Might use straight burgundy for that sash. The sash. I'm going to tone that sash. Just there. But, oh, if I mix that with a bit of... Okay, so now, okay, so under that arm, I need to add some depth of colour down there. So I'm not really, you know, making a lot of marks here, am I? Like, it's just, this is just minimum marks making. So that goes there, and that one goes there, and then if I get a bit of that with the grey, I need the grey burgundy and orange together. I might just put a few of these. How's that look? And some straight orange and grey. Okay, and straight orange down there. Oh no. Thin orange, actually. Thin orange. Vermilion, I mean. Yeah, okay, I might put a bit more thin orange up here. White, all right, make a correction. Need to make a correction there. That bit. My gesso. Let's put these bits of highlight in. A pattern on here. And maybe that's pretty weird. We'll do some reverse patterning down here. Of grey and orange pattern on the shadow side. Okay. Okay. Okay, that's a very strange looking sleeve. I think I need to maybe darken that side there a bit. there, I got rid of it. I feel like this boob is a bit wrong to do something with that boob. That's still a bit strange. What is that? Maybe that's too high. There. Maybe it needs a bit more tone under here. Boob is a hanger. Hang on, left boob. Do you mean that one? Or that one? Which one? My left or your left? See, that's the problem. That one, yeah, it's not quite right, is it? It's not right. I think it's too big. Or too, actually, I know. Just perk it up that way. Move that way. And then it's just too big, I reckon. And then lift it up a bit, so I'll get some white. Actually, some of that light colour. Lift it up there. Bit of this in grey. And then I'll lift that bit up. Doobie doobie doobie. Struggling with this boob. Hello, pussycat. It's good.
It's all right.
It's meant to be difficult, I think. So that's a bit better now. I'll lower that shadow again. I should be right. So what am I going to lower it with? Am I going to do the thin thing, or am I going to do the pinky, the mix the grey with it? I suppose I have to go with my theory. If I go with my theory, I shall get this. My theory. That's a bit higher, I think. Yeah, no, it's about there. A bit better. It's still a bit slimy. Kind of. Oh, excuse me. Excuse me, little Frank. Heaps better, heaps better. Yeah, it is better. Oh, stop it, Bubbles. That's a dog. Stop. Stop it, Bubbles. I might just need some more water. Got my tea. 3:42. I'm gonna have to go in a minute. I'm gonna have to go and sort some other stuff and get back to my other damn portrait that I'm taking a break from. Just nip that in a bit there, I think. Very, very interesting. Now I could do something down here. In fact, I'll do that, and then I will chop off and do something else. But what I'm going to do is down there. I'm going to mix orange and that grey together, and a little bit of burgundy. Okay, and put some pattern in here. Take some of this, and hi, Frank. Hello, Frank. Highlights in the shadow area. Maybe one drip. And that. And now I'm going to stop. Me too. Yeah, see you maybe later in the week. I'll be back maybe Thursday because I've got the day off on Thursday. So. Thank you for saying hi. See ya. Have a good one.